Adobe Creative Cloud plugins and integrations.
Hello and welcome, ladies and gents. My name is Christoph Kaltseis, and today I want to give a short overview about my APF-R. And APF-R means absolute point of focus reduction. This sharpening method was developed by me over the last years, and APF-R is now available as a plugin at the Adobe Marketplace. And I hope you like it. And APF-R was born for deep sky images and astronomical images. And here's the surface of a moon. It was a hard decision which image I choose for this short demo. This is the surface of the moon with nearly 10 meter focal length. You have here the small white line. That means the scale of the image is 2.35 kilometers. And APF-R will bring out some structure. Here we go. This is the plugin. And first of all, you have to press the preview button. And for the preview, zooming in, and this is very important, this is the basic calculation of the APF-R. If the blurring like this is too much visible, it is too strong. If I'm going down, the smaller value, it's weak, so it's really a weak functionality of APF-R. You can maybe use it, but the ideal way is, or the perfect way is about this, I turn on off, it should be slightly visible. And then I choose my factor. Fine means for normal wider structures or normal structures, and extra fine means for very small structures. You have to try this, but you will find your best solution for your image. I choose extra fine because it will bring out some structures of the surface, and then I press sharpening. APF-R is now calculating everything. APF-R isn't a wavelet, a high pass or deconvolution, it's different. And after APF-R had calculated everything, I kind of have here, this is my first result, I turn on, off, yeah, bring out some structures. And I have here different rendering modes of the APF-R. If we go here for 100% view of the image like this, I can show you, this is the second rendering, it's harder. This is also different rendering modes, so turning on, off, you can see it, yeah, it's different. So you can choose the best, the thing you like for your image. I choose the first one. And what I really like with Adobe Photoshop is converting into smart object. And after then this, I go to my filter and I choose my Adobe camera now, and that's fantastic. APF-R will store all, keep all dynamic ranges inside the image. And so I can use the basic adjustment. I can add a little bit of contrast, and then I reduce a little bit of highlights. And then add some clarity, very well, that's a little bit only fine. And then I go to the details, and details, fantastic. I can now sharpen the sharpened layer. Sounds crazy, but it isn't. So I adjust the sharpening here, press my Alt key, and choose the selection of the image for the details, that's fine. You normally need no noise reduction because APF-R have a normalized median layer. So I can press OK, and I get back to my Photoshop, my APF-R optimized ACR image, and I can turn it on and off. So it did a very good and very nice job. And if I make like this, take a closer look at the info line of this image. If I'm turning on, off, APF-R is reacting with the image, but it's not touching the letters. So I hope you like it. It's for all kind of images. Thank you for your attention. Bye.